defeated. For a time, it seemed we would know peace. But it was not to be. For Diablo's essence lingers in the Black Soul Stone. I cannot destroy the stone, nor allow its evil to remain within the heavens. And so it must be hidden, even from the angels. I pray that it will be enough. Your service here is finished, and you should all... Twisted angels who have come to Westmarch, murdering all who reside within the city's walls. I will find the truth of why they have come. But first, I will strike these Reapers down so the dead may find peace in the unformed land.
Sent me to find you. Malthael has taken the Black Soul Stone. You must come with me.
People are dying in the city. I have to help them.
But you and Tyriel need to form a plan. We must find Malthael.
Tell Tyria we will meet in Westmarch. Go!
It will be done. I swear it.
We're going to die!
He's coming to kill us all!
No!
I watched in horror as the guard was struck by the maiden's magic. I heard the sound of his screams until his flesh had dissolved to nothing, and only his armor-clad skeleton remained, his jaw unhinged. Blue mist swirled around his bones, coalescing into new flesh. When at last I cut him down, the phantasmal flesh exploded, leaving only a pile of armor behind.
The gates! I must find a path into the city and help those who still live.
Malthael's fallen angels have brought death to Westmarch, raising an army of Reapers from the city's slain defenders. Once, these men and women were our protectors. Now, they are our executioners, scouring the city for every living soul and putting them to the sword.
Into the streets. It's the end of the world. So many have been killed and the Reapers are everywhere.
Surely there must be survivors.
General Torian was defending a group of refugees at the old Zakaroon Cathedral, but they're likely all dead by now.
Wait, you're the witch doctor who saved Bastion's keep. You'll save us too, won't you?
That is why I have come.
Keep moving. I think we lost her. No, no!
Those with demon blood must die.
I see no demons here. Only innocent people.
Shadow touched me, and darkness spread across my vision until all I could see was blackness. It gave way to a pale light that sapped my strength. It seemed so easy. But instead, I drew upon the last of my will and fought back. Color flooded back into my sight. The shadow was right before me, and I drove my spear through it. The Revenant Shield Guards were once the personal guard of King Justinian IV. Appointed to the position for bravery and skill at arms, they accompanied the king at all times, resplendent in their ornate armor, wrought by the finest craftsmen in Westmarch. But most spectacular were their shields, which they unerringly employed in the protection of their king.
Repel these vile Reapers!
That will die.
Ah,
We found you.
Tyrion, why does Malthael wish to destroy this city?
Because he feeds on death. Every time his Reapers kill, he grows stronger. And with the prime evil gone, Malthael believes this is the perfect time to end the eternal conflict.
Humanity has nothing to do with that war.
We are the offspring of angels and demons. But when Malthael looks upon us, he sees demons.
The church! All the refugees are inside! Follow me! Akarat's Bane! This is worse than I feared!
What could this be?
Nephilim! Your soul will be mine.
Any other archer would have fled as I charged, but this one stood its ground, staring down the arrow's shaft through lifeless, empty eye sockets. Even as I swung my blade to take off its head, the thing loosed another shot. How can we fight an enemy that has no fear, nor thought for its own self-preservation?
We must do everything in our power to slow the Nephilim down, so that the collection of souls is not interrupted. It is the key to Malthael's victory.
There must be an end to this bloodshed. Where is Malthael?
I know only that he is not in Westmarch. He could have taken the Black Soul Stone anywhere in creation.
Is there a way we can determine the purpose for which he took it?
There may be. A sliver broke off when Malthael took the Soul Stone. Perhaps by studying that sliver, I can learn his plans.
You must discover its secrets. Until then, I will go bring peace to the city. Do you know what the Death Maiden was trying to do in the cathedral?
She was creating an orb that turns the living into Malthael's death creatures. A single orb can transform hundreds of innocent people every hour. And my men report two more of them out in the city.
Soul Crucibles. With two of them, Malthael has an endless supply of soldiers.
Not for long.
Westmarch originally grew from the efforts of the great General Rakis to spread his religion beyond the realms of the East. Seized by the superstitions of the Zakharum faith, he drove his paladins relentlessly across the barbaric western lands, subduing the uncivilized tribes he found there. Ultimately, he became king of them all.
After years of my pleading, the Angiris Council has finally agreed to send me in search of Malthael. I will not fail in this, as my master's presence is sorely needed in the high heavens. Owing to Malthael's growing fascination with the humans, Tyrael has suggested I begin my search on Sanctuary.
Harry, we've got to save my friends!
All know the reputation of the exorcists of Westmarch, those spiritual warriors specialized in removing demonic possession. By custom, they arrive in darkness, clad in cloaks as black as the night that conjured them. They work in—
This is all Justinian's fault! Some king he is! Justinian must have fled the city by now. It's time for the people to rise up!
You must come together as one if you are to have any hope for survival.
But this is our chance to get out from under the king's yoke!
Die.
I
encountered the most troublesome bats in the caves outside Westmarch. My companions and I had sheltered there with the intent of organizing my many records, when the miserable creatures appeared and tore several of the scrolls to pieces. Truly, the world shall be a poorer place for this lost wisdom.
You die!
Thanks for helping, but this isn't over. The king has failed us all. If you don't believe me, read this, his private journal.
How did you get this?
Well, let's just say it's from someone who cares about us common folk.
I am so weary. Why did you have to die, brother? I was never meant to be king. The nobles threaten revolt to bend me to their will. They will abandon me if I don't keep the peasants in their place. Oh, my position is hopeless.
Needs more time. A test of my skill.
After Malthael's disappearance, the Angiris Council appointed his most loyal servant, Urzael, to find him and bring him back to the High Heavens. Urzael, accompanied by the sect of maidens who were Malthael's closest followers, set out to find their absent master. They never returned.
The attacks are getting worse. They'll reach the survivors soon.
Need more time.
Days, these people can't last much longer.
You must guide them to the survivors' enclave. ready yet. Need help.
A challenge.
Need more time. What is happening?
Revolution! It's time for our oppressors to fall. The king is in the city, but we have a trap waiting for him.
Your city falls to ruins and you plot to overthrow your king? That is unwise.
What? You're not with us? Then die with our enemies!
Lord Winton, we are thrilled that you have located a surviving regiment of soldiers. With this new force, we can turn the tide and save our city. Your disagreements with the Crown are well known, but we are glad you can put them aside in this dangerous time. Long live Westmarch!
Thank you.
ready yet. Needs more time. Need more time.
Ave Obitus, Ave Interitus, in Servos Elistros in situ.
The spirits grow uneasy here. What is happening?
I'm summoning back the souls that have been stolen from these poor people in order to restore their lives.
That is forbidden. Their spirits belong in the unformed land. You must not trap them here.
Wait, what's that noise? Oh dear, this wasn't supposed to happen.
Need help! Such a sad and foolish man. You must never again seek control over the spirits. Do you understand?
Of course. Oh, of course. Bless you, good sir.
Not ready yet. Strike at your heart. Mana. Need more time. Cannot carry more.
Some of my men are pinned down in the courtyard, fighting revenants. Please help me rescue them.
I'm returning to town.
Do you know why this is happening? It's madness!
Go with your men to the survivors' enclave at the cathedral.
Thank you.
Not ready yet.
Phantasms are unlike any spirits I have seen on Sanctuary. They bear a resemblance to lesser demons, but the souls of demons are always reborn in the hells. I suspect the phantasms may be the remnants of some early Nephilim, those born more demon than angel. The great pestilence in Westmarch killed both humans and beasts alike. The panicked survivors then threw the corpses of both into the plague tunnels. Now the Reaper's presence has revived many of those interred there, with the bones of beasts rising again as skeletal crawlers, driven to kill the living.
Your evil undoes you. That creature must die. My strike is true.
The repository of bones, commonly called the plague tunnels, were originally used to bury Westmarch's indigent. However, when the great pestilence struck, the city decided the tunnels would serve just as well for plague victims, lest Westmarch become overwhelmed by the ever-increasing piles of the dead.
More time. My strike is true. the spirit aid me. I need mana. Need more time. Strike at your heart. The air reeks of slaughter. Truth bans you. Challenge! A perfect strike!
Not ready yet.
Need healing! Need more time. Heal. You are evil, more muscle. Thank you.
I did not find Malthael on Sanctuary, but I did find humans. Far too many of them. They murder and cheat one another while allowing their brothers to starve. If their true power is ever released, we are all doomed. They have a choice between good and evil, and they overwhelmingly choose evil.
That Death Maiden is controlling the Soul Crucible, but not for long.
Down upon yourself, mortal.
Thank you. I knew you would arrive in time to save me.
But how?
I am Miriam Jazia. A seer of the Vetchin people. I foresaw our meeting, but I did not see this horror. I have come to help you. There is one crucible left, and if you destroy that, the maidens will not be able to create more. There is no time to waste. We must be on our way now. Malthael, he's watching you.
I grew disgusted by humanity during my time on Sanctuary.
It would be wise for you to wait in the Survivor's Enclave. You are not safe out here.
Nonsense. You'll protect me. And after experiencing what those things do to people, let's just say I need to see you destroy the final crucible with my own eyes if I am ever to sleep again.
Seraph was on me before I knew it. A mass of its bloated flesh soundless as it floated above the ground. When I finally noticed it, I could not move. It was as though I was trapped in a waking nightmare. I looked down and saw tendrils of energy wrapped around my feet and realized it was not fear that held me, but the Seraph's magic.
A perfect strike!
I see you have much guilt over Leah's fate.
How is it you know Leah?
I see the past as well as the future. You must not let it consume you. You shouldn't be so dour. You have much to be joyful about.
This is not the time.
I have learned that in terrible situations, it is better to laugh than to cry. Perhaps when you have lost as much as I, you will understand.
When I ask the spirits if this death and destruction will end, they are silent. What do your visions say?
Of course it will end, and you will live a long and happy life.
Why would the spirits keep such knowledge from me?
Because I was not being entirely truthful. That, and you are a sort of cherish that will never believe you can be happy and content. It is wonderful to finally meet, though you are skinnier than my visions led me to expect. You just don't take care of yourself. It's always about saving the world first, isn't it?
A test of my skill. I must heal.
You are such the artist when it comes to dispatching Death's minions. Don't mind me. I'll just be waiting over here.
What was that?
That would be Urzael.
Who is he?
Urzael is the angel who commands Malthael's forces in this city. I think you made him angry.
I see. We should return to the Enclave and learn what progress Tyriel has made with the sliver. I need to go back. The spirits smile upon me.
Look, the sliver is changing.
Malthael is altering it.
Exactly. He's been gathering strength from the souls of Westmarch in order to alter the stone. Yet his purpose still eludes me.
He's killing everyone. What more do you need to know?
If we are to stop him, we must know what he plans to do next.
Urzael has done this to finish collecting the souls of Westmarch.
The time for his death has come. Where is he?
All I know is that he is in a tower somewhere in the Westmarch Heights, and that he will be quite rude to you. Before you set out to kill him, you should stop by my cart. I can enchant some items for you.
After Coraline's death, the crown passed to Justinian I through a somewhat convoluted interpretation of Zakharum's scripture. Thus began the Justinian dynasty. Seen as usurpers by many, the Justinians suffered nearly constant challenges to their rule. Finally, during the reign of Justinian III, a full-fledged insurrection broke out in the outlying region of Carthoris.
I heard Tyrael is an angel.
Malthael's influence taints man and beast alike. Even the dogs of Westmarch, once tame and gentle, have been transformed into wild, savage creatures. They hunt in packs through the streets, tearing apart their prey with ravenous hunger. I saw them rip a soldier limb from limb. When his screams stopped, they came for me. Many of the oldest noble houses in Westmarch kept massive hunting dogs on their grounds. Though docile enough in life, they've become terrors in the hands of the Reapers. Now these beasts lead the packs of smaller dogs as they chase down the citizens of Westmarch. I don't even want to record what they do to the corpses.
Help! Someone! There's someone there! Help us, please!
I do not have enough mana.
Thank you.
need more time.
It is done. The bloodline of Rakkis will once again sit on the throne of Westmarch.
And that would be you?
My grandmother was the daughter of Coralon, but he would not claim her because she was born of a courtesan, not a queen. With the peasants supporting me, Westmarch will become a place of freedom and equality. The idle rich will be no more. Of course, there will be some bloodshed. We must make a few examples, consolidate our power, a small price to pay.
I will not put the future of the people of Westmarch in the hands of a betrayer like you.
I have spent my whole life preparing for this day, you primitive heathen.
I have come to realize that my personal feelings are of no consequence. My people are dying, and they need their king. Our resistance starts today. and Lord Winton, of all people, has provided the means. These Reapers shall not have Westmarch. I swear my life on it.
I need mana.
My master has begun his work on the stone. Nothing that you do matters. Soon, demon spawn like you will be gone forever.
Enough! The spirits call for your death, and I will give it to them.
Needs more time.
The demon spawn shall perish in flames.
Need more time.
Not ready yet.
Go back. Urzael is dead. The Reapers will be easily defeated without him to lead them.
You have saved Westmarch, my friend.
But we still do not know why Malthael took the stone, and he grows stronger by the moment. Our time is running out.
That strange woman you brought here believes she can help.
She insisted on speaking with you immediately.
Tyrael's newly established rule over Westmarch did nothing to quell the civil war, which continued until she was driven mad and eventually killed by the plague. Cornelius, grandson of Justinian III and slave to the Zakharum faith, used this opening to crush the rebels once and for all and become the new king.
Cheldo, I know how to find Malthael, but you will not like what I have to tell you.
What is it?
There is only one person who knows how to find Malthael. She waits for you in the Blood Marsh, and you know her well. Adria.
Adria. She has much to answer for.
You're not going anywhere without me.
Why?
Someone has to make sure you don't kill Adria before you find out where Malthael is.
Come with me if you wish, but Adria will pay for her betrayal. Urzael and his Reapers are dead. Westmarch is safe, and its people can finally begin to rebuild. Lorath and I now go to find Adria in the Blood Marsh. She knows the way to find Malthael. And after she tells me, I will end her life.
We hid the Black Soul Stone in the deepest part of the Nephilim ruins near here. We thought it would be safe. Malthael found it all the same.
I consider myself an expert on all matters concerning boggits. The boggit itself is a small, odd creature given to foraging and burrowing. Under normal circumstances, it fears humans, but it can be incited to great violence when under the influence of magical objects. Rings in particular seem to excite them.
This is the entrance to the tomb, but someone's collapsed it.
Adria.
It looks like we'll have to find another way into the ruins. What was that?
You.
This was just one entrance to the city. There are guidestones littered across the Blood Marsh that will lead us to the main one. The guidestones are useless to most, but will reveal the correct path to a Nephilim such as yourself.
The cursed boggin is a...
There is no escape, Adria.
Remember to get the information we need before you...
Of course.
Well, that's not very reassuring.
Time.
The first time I saw a witch, she burned. Father took me to the town square to see it. Look, he said, that is the face of evil. But she looked like any other woman, and burned like anything else. Then the flames engulfed her. Her eyes found mine, and she laughed. My father could never understand. He was born into privilege and wealth, and he spent every moment of his life trying to protect it. I was his flesh and blood, but he cared more about the names in books and the faces of the paintings on the walls than his living daughter. Do you know what fear is? Fear of who you are. The fear of what your own blood would
Not ready
do
yet.
If they knew what you were. No, you could never understand it. People look to you as a savior. Have you ever thought about the lives you've taken?
Needs more time.
Fathers, lovers, daughters.
Need more mana.
I had believed my new assistant was the noisiest creature in the world, but that was before I discovered the shrieking terror. This bat-like monstrosity produces the most ear-splitting racket imaginable, and furthermore managed to make my assistant scream even louder. I think my headache will last for weeks now.
What? I'm not dead? You have my thanks, but a word of warning. These animals carry a plague and must be killed before it spreads. To create a potion to fight it, I cut one of them open and took its innards. They smell it on me. That's why they're attacking.
Trapper's snares are surprisingly effective.
Take this as my way of saying thanks. I must get back to my work.
They ask me what I see when I look into the fire. I see a burning man. I see a burning witch. I see terror and a hunger that will consume everything. What hope do the works of men have against such all-consuming hunger? I gave myself to the flames. My father burned. He screamed as the flames consumed him, and the smell was sickly sweet. He had found me. For once in his life, he had noticed me. And when he saw that the flames did not touch me, he breathed one word. It was his last.
The spirit aid me.
The guide stones. Nothing happens when I approach it.
Let me try.
There are four entrances to the Nephilim city, each one etched with a sigil. Only the correct one marks the true entrance to the tomb, however. When you activate these stones, one of the wrong sigils disappears.
Witch, they called me, but I turned it against them. When their daughter had a child that needed to disappear, when there was a sickness that none of the healers could cure, who was it they pleaded with? When they needed me, the morality they flaunted in the daylight disappeared, as it always does.
Thank you.
have to find another guide stone to learn the correct sigil.
Searching for the maggot brood has been quite an adventure. I first observed the corpse of one near the road to Westmarch, where it raised such a stench that my new assistant vomited twice on my favorite traveling cloak. The stains came out eventually, but I was sorely vexed.
Not ready yet.
That will die. This sigil marks the correct passage.
Smile upon me. This is the passage I have been searching for.
I have always wondered how much Adria relied on Diablo's power instead of her own. Based on her blood goblins, her magic is very strong. These flesh gorges are raised from earth, stone, and demon blood, and they are driven to feast on humans so they may resemble us more closely. Let's hope they don't succeed. The flesh shaman was created from the blood of the witch Adria. Because of that, the shaman is able to use magic as she does, channeling the power of blood and fire. Luckily, Adria only has so much blood to shed, and not for much longer.
I had half a mind to explore the ancient ruins outside Westmarch, and then I realized they were crawling with dreadful scarabs. Of course, these creatures do not frighten me, but they make my research much too time-consuming, and I am widely known for my efficiency, am I not?
It's almost as though the stones themselves know that a Nephilim has returned.
needs more time. Strike is true.
I have uncovered an obscure ancient tome in whose pages is recorded an impossible tale. The secret history of a race called the Nephilim, gods by another name, and their ruined civilization in the West. If this is true, how could all signs of these Nephilim be lost? But for the record of this single tome.
The truth burns you.
Needs more time.
You are dead, cops.
I strike at your heart.
Ancestors, gifted with long life, magic, and abilities far beyond ours. Yet they were still men. I wonder if these pages hold the key to unlock their powers once again. I will bring the light of Zakharum to the heathens. Here in the east, the power of Zakharum wanes, but in the west it will rise, stronger and greater than ever. Yet I have another purpose. The lost Nephilim city of Corvus lies in the west. I will find it.
Your evil undoes you. Come with me no further. When I am done, you can join me. I need mana. On you. Needs more time.
Adria birthed these golems from the blood marsh. Their bodies were formed from the water and earth of the marsh itself, while the venom of the marsh creatures gave them life. Their very skin seems to burst with the poison of this land.
My strike is true. Need more time.
We founded a settlement near the Western Sea. It will grow to be a great city in time. Now that my people are settled, I can begin my own search for the ruins of the Nephilim city, Corvus. The tome implied that it was near this very region.
If perfect strike.
Not ready yet. The way opens before me.
A taste of my skill.
My curse upon you.
Overburdened.
My strike is true. I need to go back.
We have begun searching the marsh for the ruins of Corvus. This stinking, festering swamp is punctuated by worn blocks of stone. Perhaps these ancient sentinels are all that remain of the proud Nephilim city. No, there is more to be found, I know.
More time.
The spirits aid me.
Last night, I found the ruined Nephilim city. When I stepped into the buried catacombs, I felt a stirring in my blood. And then a wondrous thing. A dim light began to glow all around me, not cast by any torch. It was as though the very stones acknowledged my presence.
You die!
Thank you.
My strike is true. I need to go back. I strike at your heart.
The Nephilim had such a strong connection to the Light that it granted them powers far beyond our own. But I believe that through the Light, they can be reborn in us. Thus, I have
not
consecrated Westmarch, a shining beacon in the West. I have taken for my sigil the Wolf of Corvus and proclaimed myself king.
Thank you.
decade later, the power of the Nephilim still escapes me. Something long ago stole it from them and keeps it hidden, even today. I have found mention of an artifact called the Worldstone, hidden in the barbarian lands. Now that my son is born, I have rallied my banners to ride to war.
My strike is true.
Needs more time.
The truth binds you.
Not ready yet. Needs more time.
My curse upon you.
Laura, you come with me, my friend. When I am done, you can join me.
You're going to kill her, aren't you?
I will do what is right.
We're all counting on you.
I must wait longer.
The truth binds you.
My strike is true.
Thank you. strike at your heart. Overburdened. I am returning to town. The spirit aid me.
Years on, the barbarians remain unconquered, and I am a man grown old and frail. My life has seen the finding of Westmarch and the discovery of the Nephilim ruins. But still, the deeper secrets elude me. I leave the task to my son, in whose blood shall carry forth the line of Nephilim kings.
Your evil undoes you.
My strike is true. Not ready yet.
That will die.
I cannot do that.
The truth bans you.
I strike at your heart. I need to go back.
Let's see where you've been hiding, Malthael.
Adria.
The angels will never suffer us to live. They cannot accept the fact that we may choose our own path. At least demons are not so rigid in their beliefs.
Angels and demons are nothing to me. I will find my own path. Yours ends here.
Diablo sent me a vision. He had returned, and you were the one who freed him.
Never.
He always finds a way. My master will return.
And yet, you will die alone. Before she died, Adria conjured an image of Pandemonium.
She was searching for Malthael. So he must be there.
Diablo will return. I have done what I can to ensure it. He always finds a way. In your heart of hearts, you know this.
I am returning to town. Malthael is in Pandemonium.
No doubt he has gone to the fortress. Malthael can hold out there until the end of time. He is forcing us to come to him.
He thinks to grow more powerful than me while skulking in the shadows like a rat.
The only way to Pandemonium is through the high heavens. Let us leave at once.
What is this?
Destroy the gate! The Nephilim is here!
Is my brother. I fought 1,000 battles by his side, and I care not that he seeks to destroy you and your kind. But my brother has grown sick, and he must be put down for his own sake. Yet I have not the heart to do this. And so it falls to you. Come, Nephilim, to Pandemonium.
Malthael tried to destroy the way to Pandemonium. He knows that I am coming for him. I will cross the Broken Land over which angel and demon have fought wars beyond counting. To the Pandemonium Fortress, where the Angel of Death waits, hiding behind its walls.
Ah!
There is a siege camp not far from here. Meet me there, and I will show you what must be done. Fearsome soldiers of hell. Having grown accustomed, patience is not one of my virtues, Nephilim. Pandemonium is a vast, chaotic realm, and many demons remain scattered throughout it. In particular, the war-scarred marauders were unwilling to return to the Hells, and they have taken to pillaging the remaining angelic outposts in the battlefields. They may not be the most powerful of their kind, but they are clever and insidious, and no strangers to war. Must I do everything for you? See the battering ram below. That is the only way you can breach the fortress gates. But it is useless without the siege runes that power it. You have one in your possession, but there are two more. You will find them on the battlefield below, imprisoned along with the demons that carried them. Once you have the runes, go to the ram. But know this, Nephilim. Even if you release Malthael from his madness, I will not thank you for it.
I do not need your thanks. The spirits smile upon me.
To Pandemonium has allowed me to see a new world, one that is almost too fantastic for mortal eyes. The ancient battlefields stretch before me, a desolate space that is occupied by small, scouring beasts. They search the lands endlessly, thriving off the magic that lingers from battles long past. I suspect that the barbed lurker is part demon, for its appearance has an aspect far too sinister to occur naturally. It expels a noxious poison worthy of the Hells, and from what I can tell, it will only feed on its own kind or the corpses of demons. One hopes it will never encounter a human. Not all of the hazards of Pandemonium lie above ground. The tunnelers roam just beneath the surface, breaking through to snatch prey in their enormous jaws. And my heroic friends ask why I wish to stay inside the fortress.
The truth bans you.
Thank you.
roams the outskirts of Pandemonium, a lumbering giant with a gaping hollow at its core. Somehow, it can hide its body away, disguising itself as a mere portal. Those who pass through it are trapped in a distant world, never to be seen again.
I have found many references to the beasts of Pandemonium in Kane's old writings. He journeyed there 20 years ago to help a band of heroes seal away the primevals, and his discoveries appear to have shaken him deeply. Sometimes he would stare outside the fortress walls, and winged beasts would appear, calling his name.
My curse on you.
Need more time.
Bans you.
That creature must die. You die.
I strike at your heart.
My strike is true.
Thank you.
needs more time.
Aid me.
The ram is here, but I must finish collecting the siege runes first.
Need more time.
Aid me.
Ready yet.
I cannot carry anymore.
I need to go back.
perfect strike.
Strike is true.
The way opens before me.
You.
I need to go back.
Perfect strike!
I strike at your heart!
More time.
The spirits aid me.
Need more time. I strike at your heart. More time. My curse upon you.
Is the Alpha and the Omega of the eternal conflict.
Need more
time. It lies at the center of all things, linking the realms of heaven and hell. Long ago, when the angels were young, the aspect of wisdom found the Eye of Anu here. He named it the World Stone, and all of heaven swore to protect it.
Sliver has revealed Malthael's plan to me, and it is worse than I could have imagined. He means to use the Black Soul Stone to capture all demonic essences, even those that linger in human hearts. If the stone is altered to rip the demonic essence out of every man, woman, and child on Sanctuary, they will all die.
No, we can still stop him. And we begin by attacking the fortress.
Malthael is fundamentally altering the Black Soul Stone. It will now pull in all the demonic essence from whatever plane of existence it finds itself in. But mankind is born of angel and demon alike. Every mortal, save myself, has demonic essence as an intrinsic part of their being. Losing that will rip their body and soul apart.
Tyriel has told me that the winged assassins were once the sages of wisdom. In return for their vow of eternal silence, they were free to roam Malthael's pools of wisdom in the high heavens. Over the millennia, they learned nearly everything about the past, the present, and even part of what would come. But could they have foreseen their dark fates? That.
Shatter the hooks! One last hit!
The gates are broken.
Pandemonium Fortress. When I fought Malthael, my sword passed through him like air. He is in a state of death and life, impervious to physical harm. Your magic is not enough. To defeat him, you must channel the power of death, as he does.
The voices of the spirits below call to me. Could they be the key?
The power of the dead. If you could become one with it, you would be as Malthael is. And you could face him. But you must find a way, quickly. Every moment, thousands die, and Malthael's power grows beyond anything I have ever seen.
The spirits welcome you. Soon, we will speak truly for the first time.
Never before have I heard a voice from the unformed land so clearly. Ancestors, I call on you for aid. Malthael is beyond my powers, and I seek your guidance.
Though Malthael consumes the spirits of Imbuiru Ekura, it has not made him invincible. He has opened himself up to you.
But how?
Are you not master of the unformed land's power?
Malthael has grasped something greater than I have. He is death itself.
But the spirits would answer your call and aid you if they could be wrested from Malthael's grasp. Go deep within the fortress and set them free.
Malthael's most trusted advisors, and his fall to darkness affected them deeply. Gone were their radiant wings and calm, balanced counsel. Now they possess only malice and cruelty, and the insatiable desire to destroy all living things. These monsters were once the most notorious and reviled criminals in Westmarch. Drawn up from the deepest, darkest cells of the city's prisons. Each was worse than the last. Heartless murderers who had butchered countless men, women, and children. In death, Malthael birthed them in forms that matched their twisted, callous souls, creating perfect instruments of slaughter. The executioners have earned their name. Before Malthael turned, his sages of wisdom occasionally reached an exceptional level of knowledge that granted them the title of Exarch. These esteemed followers would guard the Chalice of Wisdom when Malthael was away, and they were the last to leave after their master disappeared from the high heavens.
hero. I slew demons beyond count. I won battles and broke sieges, but it availed me nothing. I know that this war can have no victor, only an eternity of revenge, pride, and hatred. Tyriel does not understand. He cannot see beyond the glory of battle. In time, he may, but that day is not yet here. There must be others who seek a way out of the endless strife. Angels and demons who feel enslaved by our fate. I cannot be unique in all of creation. I know my path. I will find those disillusioned of the war and lead them.
My strike is true.
Father is content to fight the same battles and the same foes while everything turns to ashes. Though his victories might last
Needs
a day,
more time.
Or a year, or 100 years, the war will never be won so long as he and his brothers lead. There is an end to it, but fools like my father are too blind to see it.
Took prisoners. I babbled like a fool about my dreams of escaping this war. My captor freed me and said that we would meet again. Her name was Lilith, daughter of Mephisto.
Whose light was dimming. I brought him to my lair for my amusement. He surprised me. My touch seemed to breathe life into him. He raved like a madman about how he wished to escape the war. Perhaps I have found someone I can use.
Lilith is me, out of fire and flame. I could never have felt this way about a demon while I was mired in the endless war. The strain holds us prisoner to what we've been told to believe. She and I have made plans. We will bring others to our cause, and together we will escape.
cannot carry more.
I am returning to town. Given me your power?
From beyond the veil of death, the power of the spirits now resides within you as it never has. You now live in both worlds, the true one and its shadow. And it falls to you to save them both.
Of his desire. I told him that we must liberate the World Stone, and then we can be together. We will create something never imagined by those mired in the eternal conflict. A new world.
Those who follow us are strong in purpose and conviction, but we are only few. Yet if we can obtain the power of the World Stone, it will be enough. We will scale the wind shear slope, steal into the heart of the fortress, and be gone before anyone notices the stone's disappearance. Their triumphs, they die. That is wisdom.
Not ready yet.
Himself. Now go retrieve that stone. We will help as we can.
More time. Not ready yet. Needs more time. I cannot carry anymore.
I am returning to town.
Needs more time.
The Soul Stone is a born sanctuary. The blood of demons will soon be gone from all creation. You will be the last of your kind.
your mana.
That is inevitable. Death will release you from pain.
Not ready yet.
I'm returning to town.
The Black Soulstone.
Malthael destroyed it and consumed Diablo's soul.
Then Malthael's death will have released Diablo. He is free. Nephilim had done the impossible. By conquering death, he had redeemed the angels and saved all mankind. In that moment, with victory at hand, I saw the Nephilim in a new light. He is a hero who can defeat the champions of heaven and hell, and a witch doctor who protects the innocent. But within him beats a mortal heart that will one day be tempted to corruption. On that day, will he have the strength to resist, or will he be our doom?